Welcome to Hawaii. Over the next several minutes, I'd like to show you some of my favorite sailing spots from the islands of Maui and Oahu, giving you just a glimpse of what a great place this is to windsurf, at whatever your level. This is my home, Kailua, Hawaii, Kailua Bay right here, which is, to me, the most perfect windsurfing spot in the world. Uncrowded, perfect white sand, steady trade winds, nothing radical, but incredible windsurfing, and a great place to call home. Incredible as it may sound, Kailua remains completely uncrowded. With beautiful days like this, sailing basically alone around your own private islands, available all year round. For some of the most insane wave sailing around, the best, longest rides just around the corner is the secret spot that you'll never find even if you look for it, but it's right here in Kailua. Now this might not look like much, but check out how long these waves are. I'm not allowed to show you too good a day for fear of it getting crowded, but I can tell you that this spot gets bigger and better than any wave riding spot I've ever sailed. From the windward side of Oahu, we head over the Ko'olau mountain range, past Honolulu, to Hawaii's most famous landmark, Diamond Head. That also happens to be, without a doubt, Hawaii's best summertime wave sailing spot. Today's definitely a good day. One of the better days, one of the bigger days at Diamond Head in a while. From Oahu, we take off and fly east to the island of Maui, home to many of the world's top professional windsurfers. There, along the rocky northern coastline, we find the famous wave sailing spot, Ho'okipa Beach Park. Best train and compete here on and off all year round. Here's what it's like when a few of my friends are out. When the crowd finally gets to me, I usually head downwind a few hundred meters to the spot called Lanes, where uncrowded backside lefts and big jumps make it without a doubt my favorite Maui wave spot. Not to forget the speed sailors of the world, there can also occasionally be some pretty good slalom sailing here. Usually, even on my racing gear though, I have a hard time resisting the temptation of getting air.
steady trade winds and rolling ocean swells make for some of the best training grounds anywhere for the extreme sailor, and a darn good test of your equipment. This carbon slalom board is already 2 years old, and it's still going strong. With one of the biggest rideable waves in the world, and no beach for miles, this spot offers some pretty special challenges. On this particular day, Don Montague and I gambled on a tricky launching site. Don lost and was lucky to get through it without being seriously hurt as he was cleaned out by a mast-high set. Thank you.
This is the North Shore of Maui, where English is a second language. Sometimes a third language. We've got wave boards, wave sails, slalom boards, slalom sails, course board, big sails, and a surf board. So you should be able to do something. And friends of wind is not so good if you have got surfing. It's huge. You should be out there. I got $3 for lunch. You didn't hear that. What do you want?
Can I have 2 chilitos, a chicken 7-layer burrito, 4 tacos, and 2 medium Cokes, please?
There's 10, 67? With the stash.
35, 55, 55, 55, 60, 70. Yes, please.
Hot? Here, have a Pepsi. I'll put it on the cooler.
Thank you.
Ah, yes. The lunch of champions. Taco Bell. Oh, and it looks like Francisco Goya eats here as well. There's his van. Yes, Francisco Goya is eating a Taco Bell.
Sometimes our steady northeast trade winds die off, giving us what are called Kona winds that blow anywhere from southeast to southwest. Occasionally these winds produce some of the cleanest wave sailing ever. Here, Hokipa Lanes is transformed into a spot that looks some like a cross between Diamond Head and Pipeline.
Yeah.
Book your tickets now. The wind and the waves of Hawaii are waiting for you.